Hi everybody, so a happy new year to all of you. I am just from my office randomly making a vlog at the moment because I had certain things that I was going through. I wanted to share it with you. A lot of people ask me about the question that what is a Canadian experience class? What is a experience counted as? So there are two criteria to it. One is the self-employed and the other is the other criteria is always obviously the person who's not self-employed and who is actually working under somebody. So this is self-employed is not counted as Canadian experience. Now I'll tell you the law behind it. The law behind it states that if a person is self-employed, that means any person can basically just get self-employed, pay his own T4s and, you know, pay his own taxes to the government, and then thereafter, after 12 months of full-time experience, claim points. But this is not how it works. In Canada, how it works is that this who is self-employed is a question that is determined by the Canadian Revenue Agency, that is called the CRA. The CRA has its own protocol of determining who is self-employed and who is not. So in this sense, if you have an incorporation of your own, if you're coming on a, say, LMIA based work permit or anything like that, then you have a this thing, you know, you have your own company and all of that. So how are you going to claim points? Now the question that the CRA will determine is twofold. One is how much control the person has over that particular business, and if that person has 100% control and, you know, the person can hire or fire him himself also, then that person can be considered as self-employed. Now there are ways to work around of how you can not be called as self-employed for Canadian experience class purposes, and how you can, you know, go over this definition, go over things and change that dynamics of that particular definition as per the CRA. And in the second thing is, if you cannot understand that if you are, whether you're self-employed or whether you have an employee-employee relationship with your company, then is when you can take a ruling from CRA. There is a particular process to take a ruling from CRA, and usually in my clients' cases I like to do that because I like to be sure before sending all documents to the Canadian immigration that there is the ruling by CRA that the person has an employee-employee relationship with this company, the company is a separate entity, and all of those things that the CRA would write in the ruling. So be sure to know what kind of work experience you have, and also be sure to know that how you can use and verify that work experience. So bye for now, just made this short video of giving you an update of what I was reading, and yeah, you know, I like to share that kind of information. So if you have any other questions, queries, concern, do write to me, put in the comment section, and I will take it forward in my next coming vlogs. And now I'll be a little more regular in 2022. That is my commitment to myself. Okay, thanks, bye.